Hello there, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Nirav. In this session, I'll be doing a little wave analysis for the S&P 500. I'll be looking at possible price movements and possible patterns for this market. Before moving any further, I'll just like to advise that please view this video in the maximum possible quality, which is 1080p for this recording. Also try increasing the brightness of your screen for best viewing experience. Let's see what the last video was saying. It was published on 4th of February 2019 and the video was suggesting two main hypotheses as pointed out at the near the end of this video. H1 was suggesting that we will see an upward movement till 2734, which should then be seen by a correction to the downward side, and H2 was suggesting a movement to 2807, which basically the end of this white resistance box is what I meant in H2. So a move till the end of the white resistance box, which should then be followed by a corrective leg to the downward direction. Also keep in mind that in the last post, the counts were taken as a corrective move to the upper direction. However, I've simplified the counts, a little bit change has been made that we will discuss in this video. So those were the both the views, and the market was trading around 2705, as you can see over here at the red label. So let's have a look at the current market price. Currently the market is trading around 2824. Let's have a look at what transpired of the last view. So from 2705, let's just take the 4th of February over here so that there is no doubt remaining. 4th of February closing near 2713, and the H1 was 2734. Obviously H1 is not followed, and let's look at H2 was suggesting that we can see a price movement till the end of this white resistance box, which is what actually happened. We saw a price movement till the end of this resistance box, saw a spike up, leg down, retest, false break, and then a leg down for the correction. So it was definitely not the way I expected it to be. I was expecting a zigzag move down, however it's more like a flat correction to the downward direction. But overall, I would say that H2 was not completely incorrect and neither correct, because once the correction to the downward side had begun, our expectation was to see a move near the 50-60 retracement box. But what actually happened in this market is that we saw only a retracement of 23.6%, and that not of the whole leg down, but the last leg. Which is why I have a different view of this market as of now, which is represented by this count. So let's have a look at this new H1 count, which is over here, and see what has changed and what I think of this market right now. So looking at this market analysis, I will just like to point out for those of you who are not much familiar with the Elliott wave, that an impulse is a movement of price in the upward direction, even in an uptrend, which has 5 waves. As per lead wave. So an impulse in the upward direction will look something like this, or roughly like this, which can be labeled as wave 1 up, 2 down, 3 up, 4 corrective down, 5 up impulse or ending diagonal. If we compare this rough price movement on the right hand side with the actual price action on the left hand side, we can say this is wave 1 up, this is wave 2 down, followed by wave 3 up over here, wave 4 down, and wave 5 up. So what I have basically done over here is I have moved some counts, and instead of looking at this whole structure as a correction to the upward direction, I am looking at it as now an impulse in the upward direction for wave A most likely, and possibly wave 1. Both are possible scenarios, but I'll consider the wave A scenario first. So if that is the case, we can label 1 over here, 2 over here, and 3 over here, flat structure for wave 4 over here. And that would mean that wave 5 is the one in the upper direction. Now there is a slight possibility suggesting that wave 4 might still be continuing as a complex correction, but I have a reason to believe that it is already complete, which I will discuss now. So just to re-emphasize the fact, we are of the view that most likely this wave 4 is complete. Please keep in mind wave 4 by their very nature are deceptive. That's where most losses will happen if you are an elite wave trader. So even though I have a reason to believe wave 4 is complete, keep an eye out for the other possibility. So let's have a look at the reasons that I was talking about. So first of all, let's do the simplest thing, which is measure this wave 3 circle. So starting point of wave 3 to the ending point of wave 3, I have drawn this Fibonacci retracement tool. And if you see over here, 23.6 marker is coming exactly at this price level. A little bit lower, a few points lower, but almost near that level from which this price has moved to the upward direction. So that is the number one reason why I think wave four may have already completed. And secondly, if I just look at this flattish type of correction, wave four circled, we have, let me remove this stuff, let me describe what I think. So from here on, we have this wave four, right? And I'm assuming it as a flat sort of correction. So I will say this is the first leg down, second leg up, which should be followed by the next leg down. So generally, we can say that this is the first leg down labeled as A or W, second leg up is labeled as B or X. In case of complex corrections, we use the terminology of WXY in case of simple flat ABC. But overall, the measurements are the same, so I won't be differentiating in the terms of that. However, so coming back to the basic thing, the measurement is that if the wave A or W is measured and projected from the end of wave B or X, then we seem to have a ratio connecting waves A and wave C. And the ratios are a varied different numbers, but generally the maximum one we see is that the wave C or Y is 261.8 of wave A. So that is in the case that this leg is overly extended, which is the case in this scenario. And if I look at the price, you can see that 261.8 line, which was this Fibonacci Fib extension tool measuring the first leg down, A or W, projecting it from B or X end. And you can see 261.8 is exactly near the end of this price action. So that's my second reason why I think this wave four circle may have already completed. So getting back to the actual stuff, if the wave four circle is complete, that is if this analysis is the one playing out in the market, then we will have the wave five up. Now, since Elliott waves are fractal in nature, that is the 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 we discussed right away at the starting of this analysis. Fractal would mean that the waves 1, 3, and 5 will each have 5 waves inside of them. So if I were to define that in terms of this price chart, then I can say that if we magnify this wave 5, it should have a structure of 5 waves inside of it again, which we can, let's just say, label as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again of, let's just say, a circle degree to differentiate between the levels. So anyways, the basic theme is that since Elliott wave is fractal in nature, 1, 3, and 5 will again have 5 waves inside of them. So that means if this wave four circle is complete over here, we can have, or we should have, wave five circle having 5 waves inside of it. And let's have a look at if that is the case or what. So for doing that, I'll just take this point as our point of reference, which is the last leg near 2717 or the end of wave four circle, and move to a 15-minute chart. So as you can see on the 15-minute chart, we have the wave four circle ending over here at 2721. From here on, as I just mentioned, we should see a 5 leg up. Again, roughly drawing, it should look like this. And we are taking at wave 1 circle, 2 circle, 3 circle, 4 circle. So I'll just like to point out that here, instead of changing the denomination or the degree, I have just changed the colors. So basically, what I'm saying is that previously I am taking, in the higher degree, I'm taking these waves as wave 3 circle, 4 circle, and 5 circle red. And on the lower time frame, instead of changing the degree, I am just changing the colors. So again, that's whatever is convenient to you is what you should use. So let's have a look at the wave 5 red circles internals, which should have 5 waves of this CN or bluish color. Once again, I see that we have already completed the wave 1 over here, right? 2 over here. 3 circle is the what the structure we think is continuing right now. Wave 3 circle will again have 5 waves inside of it. Once again, this is the fractal nature of Elliott waves. And this wave 3 circle, since has 5 waves inside of it, they can again be labeled as simple 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If we look at it, we have, say, what, let's just say (double bracket 1, double bracket 2, double bracket 3, double bracket 4, and double bracket 5), which we seem to have 1, 2, and 3, and 4 completed as a triangle in A, B, C, D, E, and the fifth is the one which is either continuing or already complete. So basically, the theme meaning over here is that we have a sideways movement for wave 4 circle remaining, which should be followed by one last leg up, which should then give a bigger correction if this count is correct. So that's the main outlook, and we can then again go with some rough price targets for this market. Let's go to 4-hour chart for that. First thing we can do is we can measure the wave zero, or the starting point of this whole structure, take it and measure the end of wave three and project that structure from the end of wave four. If we do that, then the primary target or the minimalistic target that comes is the 38 dot retracement level, which we should mark as our target one. Thing we can do is we can mark the 61.8 level, which will be our target two. Let's just mark that as well, because after all it is there and it is a valid level. So these are the three important levels that we will look for possible reversal. Once again, the levels are just for guidance. The main thing we will look for is a completion of an impulse. It may as well complete before this T1 or target one level. And if the impulse a clear five wave movement, let me show what I really mean. A clear five wave movement like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is complete, and then we see a lag below this level, which is below the low of wave four, then we may look for shorting in this market. So that is our main hypothesis, or my main view for this market as of now. And this is suggesting what some upside movement, which should conclude near target one, or maybe a little bit higher. But overall, as soon as this upside movement is completed, we should see a bigger correction. To state it simply, on the price chart, we are expecting something of this sort, which should take this price action to the 50-60 retracement of this leg up. So that's my main view. And obviously this 50-60 level, exact precise level, would only become clear once this last leg high is determined, or the price action has completed this last impulse. That is what I would call our hypo one. Let's move on and discuss another possibility, which is not bearish at all, that I have labeled as hypo two. This is our hypo two, which is going with the theme that the wave five or the first impulse is already complete over here. So I'll just remove this counting stuff and clearly describe what I'm saying. So as we have just discussed, we are seeing an impulse in the upward direction, but in this particular count, what I've done is I've taken the wave one over here, just like the last count, wave two over here, just like the last count. But the placement of waves 3, 4, and 5 are a bit different, in the sense that wave 5, or the first impulse, that is wave A or 1 of the higher degree, is complete here. So in the previous count, it was that the wave 5 is still continuing and has one lag or small movement to the upside remaining. But in this count, I'm saying that wave 5 is already complete here. Now what that means is two possibilities remain. If wave 5 is already complete here, that is this impulse is done, then either we will have the correction continuing, that is the correction after the wave A or 1 would be or 2. So this wave B or 2 correction is either complete already, or it is still continuing. And if it's complete, then we will have a clear up lag after it. And if it's still continuing, then we will see what are the possibilities. So first, let's discuss the possibility that this B or 2 is complete. Now, the first thing that comes to mind is that if this is an impulse complete as A or 1, and this is a B or 2, then this B or 2 is already complete as a flat, most likely. I'm not saying it is. The other possibility would be that it is continuing as a complex structure, although that looks a bit less probable at this point in time, but it is still there. So let's continue with the hypo 2 sub variation number 1, which is saying B or 2 is already complete as a flat structure. And now the point to note over here is that B or 2, if complete, is very small in retracement, which would mean that the next leg up is going to be quite strong, because generally wave B or 2 would retrace a little bit more than this 23.6 retracement line. If we were to just draw it roughly here, then it is not even 23.6. So this hypo 2 sub variation is suggesting that a strong up move, if A is complete over here, A or 1 is complete over here, and B or 2 is complete over here, would be very strong. So once again, I would just like to repeat that this hypo 2 is of low probability. Subvariation 1 is again even lower probability because BR2 generally would not end like this. Now, hypotenuse subvariation number 2 is what is saying that wave BR2 is not complete but is still continuing as a sort of a WXY sort of complex correction. Now, in that case, again, a complex correction would not show much of a retracement, but it will consume some time. That is, some sideways movement will be there in price, consuming some time, and then we will again see an upward movement. So, overall, hypotenuse is suggesting sideways followed by upward movement, which is why I am thinking of it as a low probability scenario. And hypotenuse sideways to upward, let's get back to hypo 1. There is also a subvariation of hypo 1, which I'll just like to throw some light on. The subvariation is simply saying that if this wave 4 is not complete, then again we can see some time consumption over here, but overall it still means that we should see small up lag after it and then a downward movement from here on, which should be around 50-60 of the last price lag. So that is my view for now. And as for the price targets, we just discussed that the hypo once wave 5 circle can end near this target 1, target 2, or target 3 levels. I don't think it would even go near the end of 2T2 or the second target, because if this impulsive count is correct, then we are already seeing wave 4, which should just have one more leg up. So I will personally think that it will conclude or complete before this target 1 level. But once again, to summarize the possible strategy, if we are following this market with the hyper one, then the strategy would be to analyze the structure of this last leg, wait for the completion of a clear impulse, and once a clear impulse is complete, we will look for shorting this market. And the second thing is that if this market does not transpire as a complete impulse, although it looks like an impulse thus far, it does not mean it will. In that case, we will look for this other possibility that this wave 4 circle is possibly continuing as a complex correction in the sideways market, and then wait for this next leg up after the complex correction continuation over here somewhere. So those are the main outlooks for this market. I'll just like to at the end mention that please do your own analysis, because this is again my own view and I'm not liable for your trading profits or losses. You yourselves are. And frankly, if you don't know what you're doing or you can't analyze the market on your own, then what are you even doing in the market anyways? And before concluding this video, I'll also just like to mention that I have updated the video course, which is available on my website 50eyes.com, which it was previously around 4 hours. I have added lectures which make it 6 hours plus, and special new emphasis have been paid on the lectures of corrective structures. They are now expanded with more detailed lectures, and supporting documents for each lecture in PDF format has been added. So definitely have a look at that, and that's all for this discussion. I will conduct the next webinar on the coming Saturday. Links will be provided in the description and on the website's homepage. So if you're interested, you can register and talk with me in the next one. Thank you for this one. I'll see you next time.